Hello students, we are back again in our maths class, right? We have already done two classes on this topic. One was theorem and another was the solution of the exercise. So today we are going to proceed with question number 3. Okay students, so it is very important to understand what the question is demanding. We have to read the question very thoroughly, okay? Now just see, let's read the question. If the two angles of a triangle are 45 degree and 55 degree, that means what the question is saying you in the first line? That means one triangle is there. In that triangle, one angle and the other angle. One angle is 45 degree and the other angle is 55 degree. Okay? Then find the third angle. What you have to find? You have to find this third angle. Very simple question. Right? It is same like question number 1. In question number 1, this diagram was given, but now what happened? It is given only in words. Clear, students? So we can solve it easily. We don't know what is the third angle. So what we will do? Let the third angle be x. Let the third angle be x. Now easily you can write by question x plus 55 degree plus 45 degree equals to 180 degree. Why, students? We know sum of the three angles. If we add these three angles, this, this and this, what is the total sum? 180 degree. The reason is what we have to write in the bracket? Sum of all the angles of a triangle is what? 180 degree. Understood? Don't forget, this reason is very important. You have to mention this. Now, after that you can solve it. X equals to x plus this, 45 plus 40, 55 is 10, 1 carry, 100 degree equals to 180 degree. Therefore, x equals to 180 degree minus 100 degree. Therefore, x equals to 80 degree. We find out the third angle. Okay, it was our triangle. Now just you see the triangle. One is 45 degree, one is 55 degree and the third one is 80 degree. Now what type of triangle it is, I already explained you. If all the angles are less than 90 degree, what type of triangle it is? It is what? Equitangle triangle. It is equitangle triangle, right? So you can write it. Therefore measure of, since the measure of all the angles of a triangle are less than 90 degree, therefore it is an equitangle triangle. Clear, students? It is very easy. Same as question number 1. In question number 1, it was given in the diagram form and now it is given in the sentence form. Clear? So, students, therefore, here you just write this one line also again, okay? The third angle is, we have to find the third angle now. The third angle is 80 degree, right? Then, since the measure of all the angles of a triangle are less than 90 degree, it is an equitangle triangle. This is just for your explanation, okay? Okay, students, let's write question number 4. Our next question is, let's read the question, what the question is saying, and let's draw a diagram also. If the vertex angle of an isosceles triangle is 90 degree. Now, what type of triangle it is? If I draw one triangle, what type of triangle the question is saying? It is an isosceles triangle, right? In isosceles triangle, opposite sides are equal and what? Base angles are also what? Equal? Yes or no? And what is the question saying? Vertex angle. Vertex angle means, if I say this angle is what? 90 degree. Then you have to find this angle and this angle. Clear, student, the question? Find the base angle. Base angle means you have to find these two base angle. Are you clear with the question now? Now just see what we know. Let the base angles be, let's write. Let the base angles of an isosceles let the base angle of an isosceles triangle be x degree and x degree. Right? Let the base angle of isosceles triangle be x degree and x degree. Why? Because we know that base angles of an isosceles triangle are equal. It is a property of an isosceles triangle. Now, by question, if I plus all the three angles now, this I have taken x, this I have taken x. If I add them, x plus x, x degree plus x degree plus 90 degree equals to what? 180 degree. Reason? Sum of all the angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Right, student? Now, you can solve and you can find out. 180 degree minus 90 degree, then x equals to 90 degree divided by 2 equals to 45 degree, right? Therefore, the base angles of an isosceles triangle are 45 degree and 45 degree. Clear, students? What we did? It is very simple. We know the property of isosceles triangle. Base angles are equal. So, let the base angle of isosceles triangle be x and x degree. Therefore, x plus x, 90 degree equals to 180 degree. Then you just solve the equation. Therefore, the base angle of an isosceles triangle are 45 degree and 45 degree. Clear, students? Let's write next question. So, students, our question number 5. Let's see what the question number 5 is saying. The angles of a triangle are in the ratio of 2 is to 3 is to 5. That means one triangle is given, but they are in the ratio. It is given that they are in the ratio of 2, 3 and 5, not degree. They are in this ratio. That means what we can do? We know 3x, 4x, 5, 3x, 2x and 5x we can take na. So what we will write? Let the angles of a triangle be 2x, 3x and 5x. Yes? Now, by question, what you will do? You have to add all the three angles. 2x plus 3x plus 5x equals to 180 degree. Your reason is what? Sum of all the angles of a triangle is what? 180 degree. Now, add them. It is 10x equals to 180 degree. Therefore, x equals to 180 divided by 10. Therefore, x equals to 18 degree. Right? Now, you have to find the measure of angles. Therefore, the angles are, first one was what? 2x equals to 2 into 18. 2 into 18 degree is 36 degree. 3x equals to 3 into 18 equals to 54 degree. Then 5x, 5 into 18, 90 degree. Now, just see, these are the measure of one angle, right? This was a triangle. Now, one angle is 36 degree. Suppose one is 54 degree and the other one is 90 degree. If we have 90 degree in one angle, if we have 90 degree in one triangle, then it is what type of triangle? It is right angled triangle, right? What type? Your question is there now. What type of triangle it is? Therefore, it is a right angled. It is a right angled triangle. Clear, students? Next question. So, students, our next question. Let's read the next question. Find the measure of each angle of an equilateral triangle. Now, students, by hearing the term equilateral triangle, what do you come to know? If the triangle is equilateral, what do we know? That all its sides are equal and all its angles are also equal. If one angle is x, then other all angles also will be what? Will be x degree, right? If it is an equilateral triangle, we know that the measure of all the angles are equal, right? So we can write it in the beginning here. We know all the angles all the angles of an equilateral triangle are equal, right? We know this, that all the angles of an equilateral triangles are equal, right, students? So what we can do? Therefore, let the measure of each angle be x degree. Students, क्यों x degree हुआ? क्योंकि मुझे पता है कि equilateral triangle का सब angle क्या है? Same है. अगर सब angle same होगा, तो क्या होगा? अगर एक x होगा, तो बाकी दो भी क्या होगा? X होगा. Clear, students? If one angle is x, another two also will be x degree, right? Now, simply you solve it again by question. X plus x equals to 180 degree. What will be the reason? Sum of all the angles of a triangle is what? Is 180 degree. Now you solve it. Thrice x equals to 180 degree. Therefore, thrice x how? X plus x plus x. 1 plus 1 plus 1. 3. Don't get confused, students. Therefore, x equals to how much? 60 degree. Okay. So, measure of each angle of an equilateral triangle is? Measure of each angle. I'm writing it together. Okay. Measure of each angle of an equilateral triangle is? Of an equilateral triangle is what? 60 degree. Clear, students? I hope you are clear with it. If you have any doubt, you just watch the theorem part again and then you watch this video again. Okay, students? And I want all of you to note it down in your copy.